100,000 applied. And now, just 24 acts remain. Last week, the judges found out which category they'll be mentoring. This weekend, in an X Factor double bill, 24 will become 12.
I just really want this.
As the remaining contestants travel the world for one final performance.
Probably the hardest decision I've made.
I have made my decision.
And one final decision.
I want this more than anything.
Oh.
It's time.
Going through.
To face.
You're going home.
I'm sorry.
The music.
It doesn't feel right.
Welcome to The X Factor, where tonight the competition goes global, as the remaining 24 acts jet off around the world to join the judges in four locations. They are just one performance away from the finals, but for half of them, the journey will end here. That is what you call pressure. The remaining 24 acts are all making the way to the airport to find out which country they'll be flying to meet their mentor.
This is not a holiday for me. This is literally a trip that can change my whole entire life.
I feel like there's a lot of responsibility on my shoulders. My family are sort of hoping I come back with good news.
It's like we're going to meet our fate now, so yeah.
All of the acts are here except for one. Girl group True Colours were found to have lied on their application, and one was underage.
And I'm afraid you're now disqualified from the competition.
So with this news, Louis decided to bring back Harmony Hood.
It's like the second chance of a lifetime, isn't it?
And we believe in ourselves probably even more than before.
So Harmony Hood are raring to go. But the acts still don't know where they're travelling to. The over 25s are heading to Simon's house in Los Angeles. The girls will be joining Danny in Dubai. The boy is off to see Cheryl in Morocco. So that just leaves the groups.
Louis, our judge, normally he goes to Ireland, so...
We just flew in from Dublin, and basically we have to go back to Ireland.
Rain.
And more rain.
They'll be joining Louis in... Italy. The groups are in luck. It isn't Ireland, it's sunny Lake Como in Italy.
I'm delighted it's not Dublin.
So all the contestants are embarking on a potentially life-changing journey to their mentors. Only 12 of the 24 will make it through to the live studio shows. First to arrive are the groups in Italy at Lake Como.
After 5 years of being in Ireland and raining, we come to Italy for the sunshine, and guess what? It's raining. I've checked the weather in Dublin. The sun is shining in Ireland. And it's raining in Italy.
But the groups aren't letting the rain dampen their spirits. Miss Frank, Detour, Project A, Candy Rain, Harmony Hood and John and Edward get the chance to check out where they're going to be performing their final audition.
I feel really excited, a bit mesmerised by the house. It's beautiful.
Wow.
It's so gorgeous here. Like, can't wait to perform now.
So, with a welcome break in the rain, it's time for the groups to meet up with Louis.
Hello, everybody. Welcome to Italy, beautiful Lake Como. Is it better than Ireland? I don't know. Anyway, we're looking for three brilliant acts. I have somebody to help me as well, guys. Sold millions and millions of records. Will you give me a big, big applause for Mr. Ronan Keating?
Excited to be here. Thank you very much. I had to audition for Boyzone. I know how you're feeling. It's really tough. This is your moment, so, you know, you can shine today. So best of luck.
Meanwhile, in Morocco and making their way to Cheryl are the boys. Dwayne, Daniel, Joe, Lloyd, Ethan, and Ricky.
Somebody had told us I would have been standing here in the middle of Marrakesh. A couple of months ago, I would have never believed them and just told them to shut up.
They're on their way to Marrakesh now, and I'm really excited to see them all again.
There's so much to take in here, and it's just an amazing place to be, but I'm literally here for one thing, and that's to sing.
After a night's sleep, the boys finally get a chance to see where they're going to perform their last audition for Cheryl.
It's amazing. It's just truly beautiful, and
I feel so fortunate to be here.
Like, this could be my home. I could be like going, yeah, Mum, come along to my house, you know, in Morocco.
It's time for the boys to meet up with Cheryl.
It's lovely to see you all again. Welcome to Marrakesh. I'm going to put everything I've got into making this happen for whoever the three are that I'm going to take through. So to make that decision, I wanted someone who, just like me, has been through the same situation. Someone that's had massive chart success. I'd like to welcome Will Young.
Firstly, I'm really thrilled to be here. And secondly, we know how you feel and we know how important it is. So take the chance, relax, and give us some great performances.
Should be amazing.
Arriving in America, the over-25s get a taste of Los Angeles before heading to Simon's brand new house. Jamie, Daniel Pierce, Tracy, Ollie, Nicole, and Daniel Johnson.
They're gonna be excited, nervous, and then it's gonna dawn on them. They've got a thing.
This house is so... it's just amazing. Oh,
it makes you realise why you're here and what you're striving for.
It's time for the over 25s to meet up with Simon.
Welcome. How are you guys? We know why we're here today, right?
Yeah.
Okay, I've got one person I want to introduce you to. She's with me every year. Sunita.
Guys, I wanted you to have fun.
We like it. We love it.
I actually can't do this with you standing there like this. Walk backwards. I'm being serious. I can't do
this. See you shortly. Good luck.
And last but not least, the girls arrive at the Atlantis The Palm in Dubai to meet Danny. Stacey Solomon, Rachel, Despina, Stacey McLean, Nicole and Lucy.
They might feel like they're on holidays, but this is real crunch time.
Oh, my God, it's amazing.
I've never been to somewhere this gorgeous in my life.
This is crazy. I can't believe this.
I mean, this is like a taste of how the other half live.
It's time for the girls to meet up with Danny in a luxury suite.
To Dubai.
After today, only three people will be going through to the live shows. This is really tough. So I need some help to do that. I wanted to choose somebody very close to me. I'd like to introduce my sister, Kylie Minogue.
Ladies, there isn't a second chance to make a first impression, so be yourselves. I think that's the most important, and have a blast and show us what you got. I'm very excited.
I can't believe Kylie's the second judge. I didn't even say anything. Did you see me like, not talk for about 10 minutes? I was like, I could have lied. I could have died. I was like, oh my gosh.
Next, the contestants will be singing for a place in the final 12.
Welcome back to The X Factor. We're in Marrakesh with Cheryl Cole, and it's time for the boys to deliver on what's the most important audition of their lives. Yes, we're in Morocco, where it's crunch time for the boys. And Ricky, Joe, Dwayne, Lloyd, Ethan and Daniel get ready to face the mentor Cheryl.
I feel like this year is really exciting, actually, and I potentially got three winners.
First up is 18-year-old student Joe, who, despite little experience, wowed the judges in his first audition.
You've had no experience prior to this audition?
Like local gigs.
Well, how many people?
Maybe 100.
It's astonishing. I mean, you're really, really very good.
And Joe's close family have played an important role in supporting him throughout the competition.
If I was to get through, it would be great to make the family proud and so that they could enjoy the experience with me.
Do you dare to dream?
Yeah.
Nothing wrong with that. Good luck today. All right.
Thank you. 'Cause I want it all.
So it's now time for Joe to face Cheryl and guest judge Will Young.
The moment I go and sing to Cheryl today is going to be the most important moment of my life. I want this so much, and I've just got to sing me heart out.
Hello, Joe.
Hello.
How are you feeling?
Nervous.
I'd be a bit worried if you said you were.
Good luck.
Thank you.
What I gotta do to make you love me? What I gotta do to be heard? Oh, and what do I say when it's all over, babe? And sorry seems to be the hardest word. Oh, the hard.
Thank you.
That could be the most important 2 minutes of your life. How does that make you feel?
Shit.
Are you like this now? You've done it, right?
Yeah.
He's got all the different sounds to his voice.
Yeah.
Just needs to know when to use them properly.
You're so right.
My only worry is that is the control of the belting at the top.
Good luck, man. Thank you.
So Joe leaves feeling he's done as much as he can. Next to sing is Lloyd, who's just 16 years old.
How does that feel, being the youngest left in the competition?
Yeah, it's, I think it's more pressure on me because they're all older and they've got a bit more experience, I think.
In his first audition, Cheryl gave Lloyd a second chance. She believed in him from the start.
I'm from a little village in South Wales. It's mad that things like this have happened to me. I honestly can't believe it.
Lloyd knows he has to show Cheryl that she was right to back him.
I need to prove to Cheryl that I'm not just a 16-year-old boy. This is my chance to make something of myself, so I'm not going to let that go.
Hi.
Hi, Lloyd. Nervous?
A bit.
Go for it.
Open up your mind, see, like me. I open up your plans and damn, you're free. I look into your heart and you find love, love, love. So I won't hesitate no more, no more. It cannot wait. I'm yours.
Well done. Thanks, sir.
100 bet than singing Cheryl Colin William.
Brilliant.
It's been amazing.
He's really improved since his first couple of auditions, actually.
Is he? I'd be worried about his age.
Yeah.
Whether he can cope.
Yeah.
Next to sing is 18-year-old Daniel from Greater Manchester. At his first audition, Daniel sang a song from a musical, but still impressed the judges.
This could be the moment that your life changes.
Thank you.
However, at boot camp, Cheryl wasn't convinced.
I don't get it.
Don't get it.
Cheryl, he's a dark horse.
He hasn't got the X
factor. How did it feel when you realised she was going to be your judge? Were you a bit worried?
Yeah. I were a bit worried, but hopefully I can change her mind.
So the pressure is really on for Daniel. He has just one song to convince Cheryl that he should stay in the competition.
This is crunch time. I want Cheryl to sit there and think, wow.
Hi, Daniel. How are you feeling?
I've dreamt of this for so, so long, and I never thought I'd actually get to be able to do it. Oh. I want what you guys have got. I really, really do. It means a lot.
I can't live if living is without you. I can't give, I can't give anymore. I can't live if living is without you. I can't give, I can't give anymore.
Thanks,
Thank you. Thank you.
Well done.
Thank you.
How do you feel?
I feel really good. I thought a performance did me justice.
That's just turned it on its head, hasn't it?
You think you've done enough?
Yeah.
Good, I hope so. Thank you.
Thank you. It's just it's such a different type of singer, but that doesn't mean that it's not going to work on a pop show. I mean, that was really moving. Out and out, moving.
19-year-old Ethan is next to sing.
Where are you from?
Chicago, Illinois.
Ethan may be American, but since coming to the UK to study, he's found a new home.
Ever since I've come to the UK, I've always felt like this is like a home. I've just grown so fond of the place. And that's why it's so amazing to be here. This is the one thing I want to do for the rest of my life, but will I be able to?
Hello.
Hi.
How are you feeling, Ethan?
Good, nervous, but yeah. Good.
Whenever you're ready.
Okay.
Stare into space, picture my face in your hands. And I guess that's why they call it the blues. Time on my hands, could be time spent with you. Laughing like children, living like lovers. Rolling like thunder under the covers. And I guess that's why they call it the blues.
Thank you.
Thanks. I think he could be one of them people that thinks his look is going to carry him through.
He didn't do a great vocal, you know, but he's really handsome.
He definitely gets the girly vote.
And next audition, and hoping he'll give the performance of his life, is 24-year-old Dwayne.
Knowing that I'm in the top six makes my body just shiver, like, just knowing that.
Do you feel under pressure or are you pretty relaxed?
No, I do feel totally under pressure. I'm from a tough area in North London. There's knife crime and gun crime. People close to me have lost their life because of it. That's literally not a life that I want for myself. This is where my dream can begin or end. Oh, this means so much to me.
Hello, Dwayne. Prepared?
Yeah, definitely.
Good luck.
Thank you.
Turn the lights off in this place, and she shines just like a star. Come closer, come closer. And I just can't pull myself away, and I don't want to escape. I just can't stop.
Thank you.
Thank you.
I just really want this. I can't.
Oh. He started off and I thought, God, he's in the wrong key. He hasn't found his pitch as bad.
I would be worried.
When he's on it.
When he's on it.
He's amazing and he's such a nice guy.
So an emotional Dwayne has done all he can. The last to perform is 21-year-old Ricky, who's been waiting for this moment for over a year.
I thought that was it, that I would never get this opportunity again.
Ricky left the competition at boot camp last year and didn't tell his mum he was auditioning this year.
Ricky, your mum's got to be so proud of that.
But she was overjoyed to see him make it through.
I still pinch myself that I've actually made it to the last six boys. I'm not going to let that dream go. I cannot go back. To Glasgow with a no.
Hello.
Hi.
Whenever you're ready.
Close your eyes and think of me, and soon I will be there to brighten up even the darkest nights. No, winter, spring, summer or fall. All you gotta do is call, and I'll be there, yeah. You got a friend.
Thank you.
Cheers.
Ricky will absolutely pour his heart out every Saturday night.
Yeah, but whether he can deliver it week after week, there's something that's making me think I'm not sure.
Totally agree.
So it's kind of...
I think I gave it
the most passion I could give.
It's now dusk in Marrakesh, and what's been a very intense and emotional day for the six boys. And now Cheryl and Will have got some very difficult decisions to make.
Out of these six, I've got to choose my three. This is the worst bit for me. I can't bear it.
I'm probably not going to sleep at all tonight. I'm just thinking about what lies ahead tomorrow.
My concern would be he's too similar to him.
It would worry me if he was in your three going in.
Oh.
They've got my heart in their hand. I can't change anything now. A lot further that he can go, and I don't know if he even knows it yet.
I'm torn. I'm, like, really, like, 50-50 big time.
Just hope that she sees the potential in me and that she gives me that opportunity.
With a little bit of help, he could take me right through to the final.
I don't think he would deliver a performance. I think it would be a disaster.
I just don't know what to think. To have something like this taken away from you is heartbreaking.
Instinctively, you would want to see him, but something that could progress into a little star, you would see him.
It could all be taken away, and, you know, so quickly.
I don't feel scared putting him through.
I didn't like his attitude.
The one song that I sang in front of Cheryl, it's going to determine my life.
One, two, three. And that's the final three?
Done.
You agree?
Yeah. I think you've got a winner there.
Welcome back to The X Factor, where the sun is shining in Dublin, but not here in Lake Como with Louis. When the categories were revealed, the other judges seemed to think Louis had drawn the short straw.
I got the groups.
No!
Yes!
I'm quite happy. There's one or two very good groups there.
So now the pressure is on for Louis, who's desperate to repeat the success he had last year with JLS. And helping Louis in Italy is Ronan Keating.
Louis was like a father to me. He knows groups best more than anything else. There's no one better to look after them and nurture them through this whole process.
So it's time to find out what this year's groups have to offer. And first up is Project A. The girls met 3 years ago as cheerleaders for the Leeds Rhinos rugby team. Having made it through to the final 24,
I have seen them fall apart.
They now want to be the headline act themselves.
People didn't believe in us at first. They're just like, oh, 4 cheerleaders, make a band. Yeah, all right. But we've done so well, and people really do believe in us now, and they do believe we can go all the way.
How are you, girls?
How you doing?
How's it going?
Hi. Okay, girls, off you go.
And I wake up in the morning, and I step outside, and I take a deep breath, and I get real high, and I scream, what's going on?
Thank you very much.
Thanks, girls.
Thank you.
Cheers. Thank you. We'll see you later. See you.
How do you think it went, girls?
I think it went well. I think maybe you could hear the nerves a little bit in our voices,
yeah. But that's
hopefully they'll understand that.
Yeah, sure.
But, yeah.
I mean, they have something. There is something there. There's a chemistry.
They go, there's the chemistry amongst them. And they have a likability.
Yeah.
But I don't know if they would win the show.
Next up, it's girl group Candy Rain.
You girls are sexy, you don't need to dress as provocative as you are.
We did it for Simon and Louis.
But since appearing on the show, they've hit the headlines with revelations that they used to be strippers.
Everyone does have a past. Mm. I mean, you can't say that everybody's perfect. You know, we've all been through hard times in our lives.
To be actually sitting here, I feel really, really grateful. And I just think people need to just stop concentrating on what we used to do and kind of think, you know what, these girls can sing, these girls can actually perform. They're taking this competition very serious.
we smack this performance, Louis? Oh. Please put us in your top three. Yes, please.
We promise to keep our clothes on. I'm only joking.
So will Candy Rain do enough to get into Louis's final three?
Hi, girls. Girls, what's all this stuff I've been reading in the papers?
I think, well, a lot of it is actually not true and highly exaggerated.
Did you meet Simon at all in any of those clubs?
No.
No?
What song are you going to sing?
Paparazzi by Lady Gaga.
Okay.
I'm your biggest fan, I'll follow you until you love me. Papa, paparazzi. Baby, there's no other superstar, you know that I'll be. Papa, paparazzi. Real good, we dancing in the studio. Snap, snap to the shh on the radio. Don't stop for anyone. We're plastic, but we still have fun. I'm your biggest fan, I'll follow you until you love me. Papa, paparazzi.
Thanks, girls. Thank you.
Bye-bye.
I really enjoyed that. That was very strong, and yeah. They shone there. They really
totally did.
Yeah, definitely.
It's going to be hard to get girls to like them.
Yeah, I don't know if girls are going to vote for them.
I think they're good, yeah. But I don't see anything special.
Yeah, it's tough.
Next up, A Detour. The two friends from Liverpool gave a performance at boot camp that made the judges sit up and take notice.
No, I can't accept the win. Going nowhere.
I think they've really stepped up those two.
Yeah. Every stage that we've gone through, me and Paul have grown stronger. We've got better and better. We don't want to stop it now because I know we can get the yes.
Hey, lads.
Hi, Josh.
When you're ready, off you go.
So hold me towards your tiny dancer. Count the lights on the highway. And lay me down in sheets of linen. Have you had a busy day today?
Thank you very much.
Thanks, lads. See ya.
They're happy faces.
Phil, Paolo.
Oh, my word.
Well?
I felt good.
I mean,
vocally, they struggled a little bit, but I put it down to nerves.
The harmonies weren't
there. There's no chemistry between them. The harmonies were terrible. Next up, a Harmony Hood, who were given a second chance when True Colours were disqualified, and they know how lucky they are to have it.
We want to prove to Louis that bringing us back here to the next stage was the right decision. Being in this competition means everything because I don't think any of us can see ourselves going back to our regular jobs. If we did anything else, it just wouldn't complete us.
We've got two doors. One goes through, one goes home. We don't want to go home.
Hey, guys.
Hello. Hello. Okay, guys, off you go.
Yeah, never can say goodbye.
Never can say goodbye,
no.
Even through the pain and heartache seems to follow me wherever I go. I try to find my feelings, they always seem to show.
Then you try to say you're late with me, but I always have to say no. Tell me why.
Tell me why.
Is it so that I
never can say goodbye?
Never can say goodbye.
No. I never can say goodbye.
Thank you very much.
Thanks a lot.
Thank you.
See ya, thanks.
It felt like you were up there performing without any pressure. Do you know what I mean? You know what? We've been given a second chance.
Do you know what it is? That's what it is. We just...
All or nothing.
Yeah, we just...
All or nothing.
It should have been good.
Yeah, should have been a lot better.
It should have been good.
Because I know that's there. The talent is there, but they just didn't gel at all there. It didn't work.
They are great singers. And I gave them a tough song, but I was expecting a little bit more.
Next, a Miss Frank. Although the girls got a no as soloists, the judges threw them a lifeline at boot camp to come back as a group.
Really good news.
I realise that I need these girls. Like, I need them. I wouldn't want to do it without you.
I wouldn't want to do it with anyone else.
So now it's time for the girls to face Louis.
Hello, girls. How's it going?
So, girls, what does this mean to you today?
This is the crutch. Yeah. This is everything now. You know, is it like our career starts tomorrow or we just go back home?
Well, sing.
Sing.
So what you want? Ooh. See, baby, I got it. Ooh. So
non posso fermare. Di pensando che voglio andare via dalla paura, mi devo domandare. Puoi tenere la tua vita, puoi cantare. Ring, 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 ring. Now.
Is that it?
Thanks, girls.
See you later.
Thank you. See ya.
How much do you want this?
I just feel like how much at that point where it's like, did we do it?
I think they are raw talent.
Yeah,
I really
agree with you.
I think the chemistry is good between the three.
I mean, for three girls that didn't know each other, to see them like that together, bounce off each other, sing like that, really impressed.
Let's get ready to rumble!
Finally, it's twin brothers John and Edward, who together are called John and Edward. Throughout the competition, the boys have split the panel, both at the auditions.
Two of the most, particularly you, irritating people.
And it could be very, very good.
And at boot camp.
But I'm afraid it's too late.
They sang over over what I was singing.
No, I didn't.
He did, and he sang over theirs as well. That was not fair.
They're vile little creatures who would step on their mother's
head. They're 17. They're only
to have
kids.
A hit.
But now, with the biggest performance of their lives ahead of them, the boys are already focusing on what a yes from Louis could lead to.
We could be up there, like, with our album and have an album to show for who we are, and we could meet the greats like Britney Spears, Christina Aguilera, and maybe like go out with one of them. Britney Spears, she wore a belly top, now everyone wears belly tops. John and Edward have big hair, everyone's gonna have big hair.
And it all rests on their final performance.
Hey lads, off you go.
You are my fire, the one desire. Believe when I say I want it that way. Tell me why it ain't nothing but a heartache. Tell me why it ain't nothing but a mistake. Tell me why I never wanna hear.
Thanks, lads.
See you later.
Thanks, Mel. See you later.
Oh, sorry. It was so bad. Like,
where did it go wrong for you up there? Because I can tell you're not happy with it.
Yeah.
So where did it go wrong?
Like, I was practically laughing at myself, like, just looking at it. Imagine I was looking at TV and going, whoa, these guys are a joke. But not a joke. Yeah. We just wanted to do something different. So, it was so, like...
Are you kicking yourself now?
Yeah.
They should have the most chemistry between all of these acts. They're twins, they've grown up together, and they look uncomfortable beside each other.
I think people will like them.
And with all the performances over, John and Edward are left worrying more than any other group.
I don't want to be crying. You're like...
I know. What is it?
I don't know, I just feel like... go home, and then it's just like, what the hell, that's it, that's what we just remembered for, that's the end note. Yeah, like, on a bad note, like, unbelievably bad note.
Well, like missing out.
Yeah. I feel like that we just meant our best, that it could have gone well, and it didn't, but it's better just to go for it, because it could have gone well.
So, it's been a mixed bag of auditions, but for better or for worse, the groups have done all they can. Tonight, their fate lies in the hands of Louis and Ronan.
So, Ronan, we have six here. We have to pick three.
We cannot see ourselves doing anything else.
We need to keep proving him that girls' bands can do well on this show.
Do you think people at home will vote for them?
I think if they're good enough, they'll vote for them.
Yeah.
But I think they deserve a chance.
It could make or break everything to us. And
I just think us girls worked so hard to get this far, so...
Fantastic.
Ronan, that's why I like working on this show, because if somebody like that walks in, you know you've got raw talent.
The real deal.
We could be amazing, and we just want that opportunity to prove it to them that we can be amazing, and just have it taken away when they've just given it to us. It's just like...
They really disappointed me today.
Yes, and me as well.
I expected more.
There was no performance.
And there's never been a group like them before. I thought they would have been amazing.
We feel that we have done everything that we can to prove to Louis that it was the right decision to put us back in the competition.
The harmonies weren't very good, they weren't strong enough.
And Ron, I didn't feel that they really wanted it either. They didn't portray any oomph.
Yeah.
We don't want to hear that no. We want to hear that yes and take that next step in life.
I want to give them a chance.
No, I think you're crazy giving them a chance.
They could be pop stars.
If you really want to put them through, I'll back you.
We came all this way to give that performance, and we're just kind of going, what the hell was that?
We've got three yeses and three noes.
I don't believe it. Wow.
And I think I've got a potential win.
I think you definitely have a potential win.
I do.
Welcome back to The X Factor. We're here in Hollywood. It's crunch time for Simon and the over 25s. At Simon's house, Jamie, Daniel Johnson, Tracy, Ollie, Daniel Pierce and Nicole all get ready to fight for a place in his top three.
They've all got strengths and they've all got weaknesses, and I've got to sort out the weaknesses now.
First to perform is 25-year-old customer advisor Ollie, who originally charmed the judges in London. For Ollie, being at Simon's house in Los Angeles is a world away from his normal life back home.
But Essex seems a long way away now, doesn't it?
I'm an absolute million miles away at the moment, yeah. I still can't truly believe I'm here. Like a year ago, I was watching it on telly, and oh my God, I'm here now, singing in front of Simon Cowell.
So you're about to do the biggest performance of your life. How do you feel?
I feel pressure, I feel nervous. This is it now, this is the last one. I've just got to give it everything I've got and hope that Simon believes in me, believes the talent, and believes that I can do it.
Hey, Ollie.
Hey, yeah, you all right?
Nice to have you here.
Thank you.
How are you feeling?
Yeah, nervous.
Are you?
Yeah.
All right, Ollie, best of luck.
Thank you very much, thank you.
I've been so many places in my life and time. I sung a lot of songs and made some bad rhymes. I've acted out my life on stages with 10,000 people watching. But we're alone now and I'm singing a song to you.
Well done, Ollie. Thank you.
I was really nervous, wasn't
he?
Really nervous.
Yeah.
Hard song.
I really like him. But it just shows you what the nerves can do to somebody.
Do you think he did enough?
Yeah, just a couple of lines I've mucked up on, but just felt so emotional singing it, you know?
Yeah.
God.
As Ollie's left hoping it's done enough, up next to sing for Simon is 25-year-old call centre worker Tracy.
That was the best audition of today.
I wanted to be a successful performing artist ever since I was five. Now I'm here. It makes me want it so much more.
As one of 14 children, Tracy has lots of family at home supporting her, and she's hoping to put in a performance that they'll be proud of.
Everybody's so behind me, my family, my friends, everybody. I don't want to let anybody down. I really want to get to the final 12.
To cry myself to sleep at night, but that was all before he came. I thought love had to hurt to turn out right, but now it's here and it's not the same. It's not the same. He fills me.
Good for you.
That was really good. I think she's missing that star belief.
So Tracy's hoping that her last performance will be enough to get her one step closer to her dream. And the next contestant to face Simon, 31-year-old Daniel, knows all about chasing that dream. In 2002, Daniel took part in Popstars The Rivals alongside Judge Cheryl. But his dream of a pop career failed to take off. Now he's back to try and make it as a solo singer.
I really thought Popstars The Rivals could have been my big break. After I quit the band, I've just been trying really hard to make it in the industry.
For you to have been there, done that, as a boy, and now coming back as a man, does that add more pressure?
absolutely, my life has totally changed. I've got a family now. I'm the sole provider for my family, so there's a lot of pressure and stress attached to that. And I have to make my family proud of me.
Hello.
How are you? Well, you've been down this kind of road before, haven't you? Is it harder this time?
Much harder. It means everything to me, so I've got to give it everything.
Good luck, Daniel.
Thank you. These are the days of the open hand. They will not be the last. Look around now. These are the days of the beggars and the choosers. This is hard to love.
It's hard to love.
There's so much to hate.
So much to hate.
Hanging on to hold. When there is no hope to speak of, and the wounded skies above say it's much, much too late. Yeah. Well, maybe we should all be praying for time. Ooh, oh, 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 yeah. Well, maybe we should all be praying for time.
Well done, Daniel.
Thanks, guys.
Thank you. Well done. He realises this is his last shot, and he gave it 1,000,000% there. He cracked at a couple of points, but...
You could feel where he was doing.
Yeah, I like him.
Oh, well, this is horrible. I like all of them so far. Are there any bad ones?
That performance could have put you through to the live finals.
It could have.
Do you think it did?
I gave everything. I gave my heart and soul, my absolute all.
Welcome back to The X Factor and to Simon's house in Los Angeles, where before the break, three of his contestants sang for a place in the live shows. Next to perform is 31-year-old care worker Nicole, who auditioned in Birmingham. Although it wasn't until boot camp that she really shone.
And you, yeah, you're gonna love me.
Nicole had spent the last 8 years performing with her father on the club circuit. But since his death 9 months ago, has had to continue on her own.
Not only was he my dad, he was my best friend, and now obviously he's not here anymore. I've got to take that step on my own and become a solo artist and achieve the things that I want to achieve in life. I know somewhere he's out there having a look down and kind of thinking, you go, girl.
I get the impression that as this has gone on, you've actually started to believe in yourself and now you're doing it for you.
It's something that I really, really want now, and hopefully I can pull it off. Today is the biggest day of my life, and if I don't do my best today, the door will be shut and it's game over.
I went up to the mountain because you asked me to. Up over the clouds, where the sky was blue, I could see all around me. Some days I look down, afraid, afraid I will fall. And all the sun shines, I see nothing at all.
Well done, sweetheart. That was what we did.
But, I mean, she's amazing, right?
She's incredible.
Do you know, I genuinely don't know what to do now. I put the first four through. We've still got two more to go.
A lot of tension just released there.
Oh, I'm so glad that's out the way. Oh.
Next to face Simon is 27-year-old school teacher Daniel, who at his first audition blew the judges away.
That was the best first audition I have ever heard.
But at boot camp, he failed to have the same impact.
He's just a little bit of
a little,
yeah.
And is now concerned he won't be able to live up to his first performance.
The pressure just keeps on getting more and more and more. I had a really hard time at boot camp and I really messed up. It really has hit home that I've got to be better than what I've done before.
Sing it. I keep on falling in and out of love with you. Sometimes I love you, and at times I feel blue. Sometimes I feel good, and at times I feel used. See, loving you, darling, makes me so confused. See, I keep on falling in and out of love with you, baby. Never love someone where then I pay. I'm falling in and out of love with you. See, I never love someone where then I see love in you. Yeah.
A little bit over the top.
But he is good.
You think it's only some people love him, some people hate him?
Yeah, his mum might.
With only three places available, it's high stakes for everyone. And the last contestant knows exactly how much a place in the live shows could change his life. It's 34-year-old pub singer Jamie.
What I like about you, James, you're fearless.
How's it going?
All the fun and games of being in LA, and it has been amazing, all sort of have fallen away now.
It's a bigger moment than ever before in the competition because it's one song, one moment, one chance, and it all rides on this.
As the oldest contestant left in the competition, Jamie knows that the next few minutes could be life-changing.
I'm 34, and if I don't go through right now, I would have to go back to just playing in pubs and clubs again. So it all rides on this one song, this one moment, and I have to get it right. How are you feeling?
I realise what's at stake here, so...
All right, well, look, Jamie, I genuinely wish you the best of luck.
Thank you.
Every minute of that song. He didn't just sing it, there was more there. I've never seen him like that.
But he's got to start believing in himself. And I'm not sure, because of all the years he's been beaten down, that he actually knows how good he could be. And that's the problem.
You couldn't give it much more, could you?
I had nothing left to give, really, to be honest. But I gave it my heart, you know, and that's all I can do. And I think, I hope Simon liked it.
So as night falls in Los Angeles, there's a restless night ahead for all the overs. And with the performances done, Simon and Sunita have the difficult decision of choosing which three will go through to the live shows.
This was a tough day. Rabbiteers with six people and three places.
My life can take one of two different paths, and it's based on one man saying yes or no.
This is the person today, more than anybody else, was better than I thought he was going to be. Taking into account what this means to them, I'm almost tempted, just for that reason, to go, I'm going to give you a shot.
My life rides on Simon's decision, basically.
Can't even fault his voice. It's just something about them. Makes me nervous.
I'm so close. It would just mean the absolute world. I just really hope I did enough.
I think they're amazing. One of the best voices. So sweet. Great face.
I agree with everything you said.
Yay!
But I don't think they're a star. Whereas she was more interesting as a person than her.
I want to hear Simon say yes more than probably anything I've ever wanted in my life.
I think she's got a great voice. I don't think in a million years she could win the competition.
I think it could be a surprise.
He disappointed me more than anybody else today.
He's a heartthrob, definitely a pop star.
But he's not as good as her.
He is a star.
No, Sunita, he is a risk.
I'm just literally a step away from really having a great chance of fulfilling the biggest dream of my life.
He's one of the performers that week in, week out, the audience is going to tune in especially to see.
I just wonder with him whether he's overthinking it. Worries me.
Even though we're so close, it could be over just like that.
This is my top three.
This is it.
Welcome back to The X Factor. We're here in Dubai. It's time for the girls to sing their hearts out. Yes, we're at the breathtaking Atlantis The Palm in Dubai, where the most important audition of their lives is fast approaching for the girls. With only three spots available in the live shows, it's time for Stacey Solomon, Rachel, Despina, Lucy, Nicole and Stacey McLean to fight for a place in Danny's top three.
I can't imagine how they feel, you know, the pressure of this incredible performance that's one step away from the final live shows.
Danny's picked a song for each of them to perform, and it's a song that could change their lives forever. Plus, there's the added pressure of performing in front of a music legend.
My sister, Kylie Minogue. Hi, girls.
It's really exciting to be here today, next to my sister, and sharing those decisions. I'm so excited.
The first singer of the day is 19-year-old Stacey Solomon from Essex, who surprised the judges at the London auditions.
Where are you from, Stacey?
Dagenham.
No.
What a wonderful world.
That completely took me by surprise, that performance.
But single mum Stacey knows this audition is her one chance to make a future for herself and a young son, Zach.
Everything you do is for your children. But I just think, like, wouldn't it be nice to just be good at something and, like, make everyone proud of you and then, like, be in a position where you can make everyone happy around you.
Hi.
Hi.
What would you most be looking forward to if this dream was to start rolling?
Oh, everything. I can't even, like, you know, you just think you can't think of something that's so amazing. Like, I can't think of something that would be so, like, unbelievable. It would mean everything to me.
It's beyond your wildest dreams.
Yeah, beyond any dream.
So. Once in a lullaby.
Thank lovely tone to her voice, though.
She sings and she looks around the room like, was that okay? And I'm thinking I want to jump up and go, yes, it's okay. Yeah,
I guess she's going to need to believe in herself.
How was it for you?
I don't know, I think it was all right. I think.
Did you enjoy it?
Yeah, well, as much as you can enjoy it when your legs are up.
Up next is 20-year-old Stacey McLean from Blackpool, who united the judges in Manchester. I can feel
it from the start. It's a yes.
Yes, yes.
And is praying success today will transform her from an office worker to a pop superstar.
I don't want to go back to my 9-to-5 office job. As much as I love the people that I work with, I want to be singing, I want to be performing, and I want to be here, and nothing else is going to change that.
How does it feel to be, you know, potentially one performance away from studio?
I actually can't believe I've made it this far already. There's no room for mistakes now, so it's really important that it's perfect.
Sometimes I run, sometimes I hide, sometimes I'm scared of you, but all I really want is to hold you tight, treat you right, be with you day. Baby, all I need is time. Just hang around and you'll see there's nowhere I'd rather be. If you love me, trust in me the way that I trust in you.
Thank you. She kind of looked really nervous.
I'd be interested to see how she would handle the incredible range of songs that you asked him to sing during the live shows. Mm.
Up next is 18-year-old Rachel, who was amazed to get through her first audition in London.
I ain't got a you.
You're through to the next round.
Thank you very much.
And is even more shocked to have made it to Dubai.
Just, I keep getting surprised. This is just the judges' houses, and I'm here. So imagine if I've like won the X Factor, where would I be? And I can't even take this in. This is mad.
It's tough though. You know, you're in a really, really hard category this year.
I know. The girls are on it, like seriously. And you know, we want to get to the last shows, and you know, it's so scary. But you just got to do it.
Nobody knows. Nobody knows but me that I sometimes cry. If I could pretend that I'm asleep when my tears start to fall, I peek out from behind these walls. I said nobody knows. Nobody knows. Baby, all your secrets safe with me. There's nowhere else in the world that I would ever be. And baby, don't it feel like you're all alone? Who's gonna be there after the last angel has flown? And I've lost my way back home. I think nobody knows.
Thank you. See you later.
Hey. Hey, raise your eyes.
The main thing for me is you've got to connect with the emotion of the song.
Yeah.
You definitely did that. Tick.
Yeah, tick. Engaging. Tick.
There were just two bits I thought she was just going to smash that through.
And it didn't.
That was a big mistake.
Up next is 20-year-old Despina, whose large Cypriot family spurred her on to success at her London audition.
You have got four massive yeses. Congratulations.
But far from home, their expectations are weighing heavily on her mind.
Yeah, I'm really feeling the pressure today. I'm so scared I'm going to let my family down, and I just feel so disappointed in myself. Yeah, I can't go home with a note. It just means so much to me. I just don't want to do it.
When there's no one else, look inside yourself. Like your oldest friend, just trust the voice within, and you'll find your strength that will guide your way. You'll learn to begin to trust
song to sing.
She made it seem pretty easy, though.
She made it seem easy. I'm not sure that she put her stamp on it. I'm not sure that she showed me something that was different.
Do you think on that you might have done enough?
I hope so. I don't know.
Next to perform is 18-year-old Lucy, whose tiny Welsh village came to support her at the Cardiff auditions.
This is why we come to Wales.
I've never been this far from home, no. This is amazing. I mean, I'm on the other side of the world. I am on the other side of the world, aren't I? I'm not just being really thick, yeah. Where I come from, I love it. To my little village, on top of a hill, with the farmers and the sheep. I love all the people, and their support so far has been so amazing.
It's been a really supportive town in Wales, and you know, you obviously want to do it for them as well, right?
Yeah, I mean, if I went home with a no, I had to tell all those people, I couldn't do it. Breathe.
Anything for you, though you're not. Since you said we're through, you know it seems like years. Time keeps dragging on, and forever's been and gone. Still I can't figure what went wrong. Still I do anything for you. I'll play your game. You hurt me through and through. You can have your way. I can't pretend each time I see you that I don't care and I don't need you. But though inside I feel like dying, you know you'll never see me crying.
Thank you. Thank you very much. See you later.
She's got great control. She's got the boys. But it's having that little bit of pizzazz inside yourself. I'm worrying if she has that.
The final singer to meet the Minogue sisters is 19-year-old Nicole from Bristol, who's nervous about how to perform the song Danny's chosen for her.
Kind of worried that it's such like a well-known song and like such a classic. I'm not sure if I should like put my own mix to it or just keep it to the original.
With the pressure mounting, Nicole's thoughts turn to her family.
I haven't spoken to my dad in a couple of years, and if he sees me get through, I think we could get to know each other again.
Lately I've been feeling kind of strange, with no vivid reason I can't hide. Yet the thought of leaving you is leaving me on my mind. Lately
later.
I feel like crying for her.
You could see it going through her eyes. I don't know where I am in the song and I don't know the words. I mean, granted, you can hear she's got an amazing voice. I love the quality and the tone of her voice. It's beautiful. I think what maybe she did was to try and change it too much and lost her way with it. Oh!
I just put so much pressure on myself. Oh my God. Oh my God.
So that is it. The girls have done all they can, and now Danny and Carly have got some very tough decisions to make.
Only three can go through. Oh, this is really hard. She didn't stand out to me originally, but as we've gone on, she's just continued to get better and better.
I am still worried because I don't know what I'd do if it wasn't her.
Beautiful voice.
I'm just worried she's not ready.
This is my future. There's just nothing else.
This girl is absolutely the first one going straight through.
In total agreement.
I hope that I do make it through. But if I don't, my dream's sort of over.
Thinking who's got that star potential, selling records, this is what you do.
Getting through to the live shows is just everything that I've been working so hard for.
It's tough. This is a really good category. They could all do it. I can't decide between these two.
This is like the biggest chance of my life. I could go from being nothing to maybe being something.
I would go like that.
I am so determined, like I've wanted this for so long.
I've made a decision.
Well done.
That's it, done.
Tomorrow night, the final 24 will find out who's in and who's out.
I just want my chance.
I really want to make it. I don't want to go home now.
This is it. This is make or break.
To know that it could be taken away so quickly.
I want this more than anything.
Oh, probably the hardest decision I made.
My God!
That's The X Factor. Tomorrow night at 8 p.m.
You're going home.
Going through?
I'm sorry.
It doesn't feel right.
So we'll need our tissues tomorrow night then. Who's done enough to get through, as you heard? More from the judges' houses. And it's make or break time tomorrow evening at 8. Not to be missed, that's for sure. It's movie time next tonight. Owen Wilson is kind of outstaying his welcome somewhat in You, Me and Dupree after the break.